I do not mean to diminish our accomplishments, but until we identify the ones who ordered the fires set, our work is far from finished.
Between the various conservative and religious factions in Ishgard, I dare say there's no shortage of parties who would like to see the status quo preserved. Do any likely suspects spring to mind?
Far too many to count.
Lord Commander, your wounds.
Are healing well. Thank you. Time is of the essence. Lest we forget, these men would sooner put their own city to the torch than see it change. When our enemies learn that we have apprehended their arsonist, there is no telling how they will react.
Lord Commander, an armed mob has seized control of the vault.
And now we know. Tell us what happened, sir. Spare no detail.
We were directing refugees into the Basilica, as you ordered, when all of a sudden, men brandishing weapons were all around us. It happened so fast, my lord. We had no time to respond. They've taken the refugees hostage and barricaded themselves inside the vault.
And they sent you to deliver their demands.
They, the true brothers of the faith, demand that a conclave to select the next archbishop be held forthwith. Furthermore, they declare that you, Lord Commander, are guilty of patricide and high treason, and that you must surrender yourself at once to receive of the Fury's judgment.
Ridiculous! And do they honestly think that executing Sir Emmerich would change anything? That the truth will somehow die with him?
These fundamentalists rage against the passing of the old ways, unable to accept there can be no going back.
Given the fanciful nature of their demands, a peaceful resolution does not seem likely. If the hostages are to be rescued, it will be by force, I fear.
Agreed. Lucia, take a contingent of knights and establish a perimeter outside the entrance.
At once, Lord Commander.
Hilda, I need your people out in force throughout the broom. When word spreads of the situation, the friends and family of the hostages may try to take matters into their own hands. I will not give these militants more targets. I shall lead the assault on the vault. Master Alfano, can I count on the support of the Scions?
Of course.
We are in your debt.
I shall join you as well, Lord Commander.
Your assistance is most welcome, Lord Artoirel. To arms, then, friends. Time is against us.
Thank you.
with you!
Thank you.
Where is he? Where is he? You have nowhere to run. Release the girl and surrender.
Surrender to whom? The blasphemer who throws wide the gates to our enemy? Who breaks bread with him and calls him brother? Ungodly swine! I would sooner die than surrender to you.
Is it godly to spill the blood of an innocent child? To burn the homes of your brothers? Tell me, priest, is that godly?
Do not speak to me of godliness, heathen! Your father's blood is on your hands, as is hers!
Well met, knight. Mayhap I chose an inopportune moment.
Not at all. Pray forgive us this most unworthy reception. We are honored to have you with us, and right glad of your aid.
Fortune delivered the child unto me. I had but to receive her.
Thank you for saving me.
Thou art welcome, child.
Never did I think to be indebted to so unexpected a savior. But full glad am I to be so.
Friend of Izel, warrior of warriors, I had hoped to meet with thee. I bear a message from my sire.
From Freysfelder?
Upon returning to our lands, Nidhogg's shade did sing unto his brood, and they, for skies unknown, did then take wing. This thou must know, for your fates are inextricably bound.
What of Estinian? Is he truly lost to us?
Such matters are beyond my ken. I but bear my father's words. Take from them what thou wilt. Fare you well, mortals.
It is as they say, then. A great white dragon swooped down from the heavens to rescue an innocent child.
A most unexpected turn of events, but not an unwelcome one. The people will not soon forget this day.
Yet how will they choose to remember it, Sir Emmerich? And will these events serve to bring man and dragon closer together, or drive a deeper wedge between brothers? After 1,000 years, the world these men once knew is changing, and with ungentle swiftness to boot. Though their actions are misguided, their sentiments are only to be expected. You may be sure that others will rally to their cause. I share your desire for a lasting peace with the Javanians, I do. But I would not see it built on the bones of our countrymen, nor on our own. I see much of Haurchefant in you, and I could not bear to mourn the passing of another son.
Lord Edmund.
Thank you.
Vidofnir should chance to arrive even as the girl fell. Truly, I could not have planned it better myself.
Ah, good. We were afraid you might have left.
A shield, my lord?
Fit for a true knight. An expression of our gratitude to you and yours, long overdue. But there is something else I would discuss ere you part. Something which cannot leave this room. My father will soon step down as head of our house. Sir Emmerich was not the only one to fall under suspicion following the death of the Archbishop. There are some who believe my father complicit in a coup d'etat. Thus he intends to renounce his title to absolve our house of suspicion and secure the support of our peers.
Surely there must be another way to convince houses Durandair and Zamael.
So I said to him. Alas, he will not budge. Ever since I was a child, I knew that I would one day succeed my father. The thought of it filled me with pride. Yet once I learned the day was at hand, my heart was filled with naught but dread. Our legacy is built upon the lies of our forefathers. In accepting this title, am I not perpetuating this injustice? Why should I become the next count?
Oh.
You sound just like him. Aye, I suspect that is what Haurchefant would have said. To aid those in need. When you look on that shield, I trust you will remember his words. And should I once more find my resolve wavering, I ask that you show me the way. You were a brother to Haurchefant. Will you be a brother to me as well? Come, Emmanuelaine. There's much to be done. For Father, and for Sir Emmerich, and for Ishgard.
To think we share the same blood. Pray excuse us.
Those were the days of promises and vows, of tentative first steps into an uncertain future. A future shaped by the choices we made in ways we could never have foreseen. Born of good and evil, of light and darkness, and shepherded by our hand. Be it for weal, or be it for woe.
Thank you. Well done, sir. And with that, I believe we are ready to proceed.
Let us be about our business, then. The next patrol may not be so credulous.
Why must you be so disappointingly brusque?
You're not at all as Minfilia described, you know. I don't think you've favoured me with so much as a single compliment since we set out. Tell me, did your time in the wilderness sap you of all your charm? Or are you holding it in reserve for your beloved?
This is neither the time nor the place.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but when I'm risking life and limb infiltrating an Imperial castrum, I like to be sure of my comrades' motivations.
I see now where Alfino gets it from. Minfilia is dear to me, it is true, but not in the way you think. 15 years passed when she was still but a child. There was an incident at a parade. A gubu broke free of its fetters and ran amok through the streets of Uldar. Had I been more attentive, I could have prevented it. But I was distracted, and her father was killed. I feared she would never recover. But in the years that followed, she showed herself to be more resilient than I had ever imagined. And when she learned of her gift, she did not flinch from the responsibility, but sought to guide others on the path. She touched the hearts of all around her. Mine, Louis-Soir, every science. In those dark days following the calamity, she was our guiding light, our hope for a brighter future. She had so many dreams, and I would give anything to make them come true.
My apologies. I can see she means the world to you. I did not mean to pick at old scars.
No harm done, I assure you. But fair is fair, my lady. What is Minfilia to you?
You mean you don't know? Only my dearest friend. When I finally emerged from my torpor, I learned that nary a day had passed without her asking after me. She never gave up hope. And neither will I.
Then for Minfilia's sake, let us pray that these vestiges of Hydaelyn's intervention will lead us to her.
you.